You're watching Greater Brockton. Mark Lindy, your host, and I have Nancy Krushas back, who is going to tell us about an event that happens every year in Brockton. It happens every year in the world. Summer Solstice 2019, which is Friday the 21st.
Friday the 21st.
In the late afternoon to
yes,
early evening.
Yes, 4 to 8 p.m. It's going to be over at the Salisbury Park next to Pliff School.
Okay. Which is a wonderful park.
It's a beautiful park.
It's a beautiful park. It's always been my hope at some point in time that someday, somehow, we're going to get a hat shell in Salisbury Park.
Oh, that would be nice, too.
So there would be an outdoor performance venue. If Quincy can have mini Fenway, Brockton can have mini hat shell. That's always been my dream. Got to work with the flooding and the river and all that stuff over there. But I love that park. I always have. My son went there when it was Plouffe Kindergarten.
Okay.
When it was first opened. And it's just a nice part of downtown.
It really is. It's a very nice area. And there's even at the Plouffe School, there's a little park in back of the school with
right.
the gazebo. We're not using that. We're using the main park.
And there's all sorts of things that happens there. The Salisbury Park Reunion
yep.
every year happens over
right.
there. So this says free fun for everyone. Games, music, food. Councilor Beauregard told me about it,
yes,
and then she
she's in
worked
charge.
To get you to come on and be on TV because she does host her own show, and I think she may have actually promoted it in her own show.
Oh,
but
okay.
she sent you over to me, which is great. And so tell us a little bit more about what you're going to do.
We're going to have music. Thunderbolt Productions. My son Jason Krushas will be doing some DJing. We're going to have games, outdoor games for the kids. I've got balls and jump ropes and we've got cornhole and we're going to have frisbees and kites and just a lot of things that the kids don't usually get to play with, and we're going to be able to play with the kids and have some outdoor activities. I'm going to have some refreshments, probably water, some packages of cookies and crackers and things like that for them. Everything is free. They come, they can bring a blanket, they can bring a picnic supper or whatever they want to do, and just enjoy a beautiful afternoon, have some fun. It's family-oriented. That's all we really want to do is do family-oriented.
And I like the timetable because if people can't get there because they're still at work,
right.
there's still some time
yes.
to get over there.
Yes, and it's, the sun will be up late. That's the longest day of the year.
Right.
So that's why we have it from 4 to 8 p.m. because the sun will still be shining, we hope, at 8 o'clock, and we can still be out there playing with the kids.
We're finally getting spring / summer and some warmer weather.
We
Today
really
was
hope.
A little cold and drizzly, but I think yeah. it was crying for the Bruins losing last night.
Oh, I know. That was too bad.
But there's a nice sun on the flyer
yep.
with... Sunglasses. So there
right.
you go. And I know this has always been a thing that Anne Beauregard's done. She's been very...
She has been doing
she
it
She did it at the library. She did it downtown. It's moved
she
around
did, yep.
quite a bit. Our known school,
our
I think,
school.
At one point.
Yep.
So this is a great location. It's right in Ward 5, yep. which is her ward.
Right, right. So. And she wanted to keep it downtown.
Yeah.
And that's important because, I mean, that's a residential area.
Mm-hmm.
And so hopefully we'll get some more of the residents and their kids to come out. School will be out. I guess school is getting out the 19th, I
yep.
think it is.
Yeah.
And so school will be out, but you know, hopefully they'll be out playing in the park anyway.
Yeah, I wonder when they open the pool. I'm not sure. I'm going to have
pool,
to bring
yeah,
Mr. Carpenter on.
The pool
on.
Is not going to be open that much. We're running, we have, to, there's no electricity at the park, and that's
okay.
another issue.
Yeah.
And so we're running electricity out of the pool house.
Okay.
But the pool will not be open.
Okay, there you go. That answers my question. Do you need any help to do this? Are you looking for any kind of volunteers?
We would love to have volunteers come and play with the kids. There's just so much... the adults can do because we're running around doing other things. So we have asked Love Alliance to come. Haven't heard back from them. Anne has a couple of volunteers that have offered to come and help. But anybody who wants to come and play ball and play, throw frisbees back and forth with the kids, and you know, do fun games.
It's real activities because most
yeah.
of the time, kids and everybody
and
is playing with this,
yeah.
and there's no socialization.
This right.
is I had Lynn Smith on another segment, and you know, there's reading in the park for Frederick Douglass
yep.
Avenue. There's a movie night going on.
Right.
I really admire all the different groups that try to
yeah.
the DW Field Park Association.
Right.
Everybody that
stuff.
Makes Brockton what
right.
Brockton is.
Well, Keith Park, we just had the Flag Day picnic.
Yeah,
and we had. a really good number of, I think there was like probably 80 to 90 family, kids and adults, and the kids had a blast.
Yeah.
They were doing relay races and playing, you know, with frisbees and jump ropes and stuff like that. And so that's what we're trying to do too, so that there are things for the kids and the families to do in Brockton. There's lots of things to do, but people don't know about them. Mm-hmm. And so when you try to have something, you try to advertise as much as possible to get the residents to come. You know, that's the main thing we're trying to do, is get the people out and get them involved with each other.
That's why we have you here, because we try to promote it, and we're going to run this all the way up till the day of.
Okay.
So people will see it. It'll be on. We can certainly give the link. I know Ann does some stuff on Facebook.
Yes.
We can take the link and put it on her page, or
yep,
your page, or anybody's
right
page.
I'll put it on my page and, you know, share it with Brockton. I don't know if she shares it with the Brockton Hub or not, but I will.
Yeah, and we have it on our Brockton community. Usually when we do this, it goes on cable first,
yep,
and then we put it on our Facebook page, Brockton Community Access Facebook page, and people can share it and do whatever they want.
Yeah, because I sent you one email, so you would have that, so you could post it.
And
I brought more for you to have.
We'll also send a camera over there that day.
Oh,
hopefully.
Wonderful.
In the early part, probably, we have TV shows in the studio starting at 6:30,
okay,
but the 4 o'clock time frame, send somebody over there and have some fun. It might even be me. Who knows?
Oh, that'll be fun too.
Okay.
You can come and see what we're all about.
Any contact number, or, you know, for more information or anything?
I don't know. I don't want to give out Ann's number, and I don't have, I mean,
okay,
they can just check Facebook. I mean, I'll put it on the Brockton Hub tonight,
okay,
and then people can, you know, comment on that if they want.
Sounds good. Sounds good. Thanks for being here.
Thank you.
Everything that you do for Brockton.
Oh,
appreciate
thank
it.
You.
You're watching Greater Brockton. Mark Lindy, your host. Stay tuned for more events, places, people, and faces right here in the City of Champions.